What if I told you that in 2025, scientists finally approved the first real breakthrough that could end AIDS forever? For over 40 years, HIV has been one of humanity's greatest enemies, a virus so smart it hides inside our own DNA, mutates faster than the flu, and has taken the lives of more than 40 million people worldwide. But now, something unprecedented has happened. A revolutionary injection, often called the HIV vaccine, has just been approved in the United States. Some experts are calling it the most important medical advancement of the last three decades. But here's the question: how does it actually work? Why do scientists say it's not technically a vaccine? And most importantly, could this be the beginning of the end for HIV? Stay with me, because in today's video, we're going to uncover the science behind this milestone, the hidden weakness of the virus, and what the future of HIV prevention really looks like. And if you care about health, science, and medical breakthroughs that can change lives, make sure to subscribe, like this video, and share it, because what you're about to learn is knowledge that the world needs to hear. A milestone in 2025, the revolutionary HIV vaccine. In June 2025, something that once seemed impossible finally became reality. The approval of the first long-acting injection capable of preventing HIV infection. For decades, researchers tried and failed to design a true HIV vaccine. The virus was simply too elusive. But now, this new medical innovation, known as Lenacapavir, has been described as the closest humanity has ever come to a real vaccine against AIDS. In clinical trials, participants who received just two injections per year showed a 96% reduction in HIV infection risk. That is a staggering level of protection, even higher than the daily preventive pills currently available. Why is this such a big deal? Because for the first time, prevention no longer depends on remembering to take pills every day, or using condoms in every sexual encounter, or starting medication immediately after exposure. With this injection, the protection lasts for months, a game changer for global health. The approval in the United States was hailed by scientists as a turning point, not just for HIV research, but for infectious disease medicine as a whole. Some experts have even called it the most important medical breakthrough of the last 30 years, on par with the discovery of antiretroviral therapy in the 1990s or the COVID-19 vaccines in 2020. This is more than just another drug. It represents hope, hope that we may finally stop one of the deadliest pandemics in human history. Why HIV has always been one of medicine's greatest challenges. To understand why this new injection is so revolutionary, we need to first understand the enemy. HIV is unlike almost any other virus humanity has faced. The key problem is that HIV doesn't just attack the body. It attacks the very cells that are supposed to defend us. Specifically, it destroys CD4 T lymphocytes, the commanders of our immune army. Without them, even minor infections become deadly. And over time, the body collapses into AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. But that's not all. HIV is a master of disguise. While most viruses mutate, HIV mutates at a speed that makes it nearly impossible for the immune system, or scientists, to keep up. Imagine trying to hit a moving target that changes shape every second. A treatment or vaccine that works against one strain today may become useless tomorrow. And then comes its most dangerous trick, integration into human DNA. Once HIV infects a cell, it doesn't just float around in the bloodstream, it hides inside our genetic code. Even if antiretroviral drugs reduce the virus in the blood to undetectable levels, the viral DNA remains locked inside the cells, ready to reactivate if treatment stops. This triple challenge, destroying the immune system, mutating relentlessly, and hiding inside DNA, is why HIV has been called the most difficult virus in modern medicine. For decades, researchers feared a true vaccine might be impossible. And yet, science found a way to fight back. The story of how we went from hopelessness to life-saving treatments is one of the greatest triumphs in medical history. From death sentence to chronic condition, the rise of antiretroviral therapy. Back in the 1980s, receiving an HIV diagnosis, was almost always a death sentence. Within just a few years, the virus would destroy the immune system, leaving patients defenseless against infections that healthy people could fight off easily. Hospitals were filled with young men and women dying from diseases that normally wouldn't kill anyone with a working immune system. Fear and stigma spread almost as fast as the virus itself. But in the mid-1990s, science achieved a breakthrough: antiretroviral therapy, or ART. These drugs target different stages of the HIV life cycle, stopping the virus from multiplying. Suddenly, HIV was no longer an automatic death sentence. It became a chronic condition. With consistent treatment, the amount of virus in the blood, known as the viral load, can be reduced to levels so low they are undetectable. Patients don't develop AIDS, they live near normal lifespans, and most importantly, they can't transmit the virus to others. This is the foundation of the famous phrase, undetectable, untransmittable. Still, there is a catch. ART doesn't eliminate HIV completely. The virus hides in reservoirs inside the body, waiting for the chance to return if treatment stops. That means patients must take medication every day for the rest of their lives. This daily burden has been one of the biggest challenges in the fight against HIV. Not everyone has access to treatment, and even when they do, side effects, costs, or simply forgetting to take the pills can undermine their effectiveness. So while ART transformed HIV from a deadly disease into something manageable, the dream of a one-time cure or a long-lasting prevention strategy remained out of reach. And that's where the next chapter of this story begins. The invention of medicines designed not just to treat, but to prevent infection before it even happens. The first steps in prevention, PEP and PrEP. If antiretroviral therapy was a revolution for people already living with HIV, the next breakthrough was prevention, stopping the virus before it ever takes hold. In the late 1990s, doctors discovered that the same drugs used to treat HIV could also protect someone right after a potential exposure. This strategy became known as PEP, post-exposure prophylaxis. If started within 72 hours of risky contact, PEP can reduce the chance of infection by more than 80%. But it comes with challenges. The treatment lasts 28 days, side effects like nausea and fatigue are common, and many people abandon the regimen before finishing it. Then came PrEP, pre-exposure prophylaxis. Approved in the United States in 2012, PrEP was a game changer. Instead of reacting after exposure, people at higher risk could take a daily pill to dramatically reduce their chances of infection. In fact, by over 99% when taken correctly. For the first time, HIV prevention was no longer limited to condoms or chance. But there were still problems. Daily pills require discipline. Missing doses can leave someone unprotected, and stigma often discouraged people from seeking PrEP even when they needed it most. Accessibility was also unequal. Some communities embraced it, while others never even heard of it. So while PEP and PrEP proved that prevention was possible, they also highlighted the biggest gap: the need for something long-lasting, discreet, and reliable. Something that didn't depend on daily compliance. That missing piece would finally appear with a surprising discovery: a hidden weakness in the virus itself. HIV's hidden weakness, the capsid discovery. For decades, scientists focused almost entirely on HIV's genetic material, the viral DNA that hides inside human cells. But in the early 2000s, researchers made an unexpected discovery. The capsid, the protective protein shell of the virus, wasn't just packaging. It played a critical role in infection itself. The capsid is like armor. It shields the virus as it travels through the bloodstream, protecting it from destruction. More importantly, it helps the virus reach the cell nucleus, where HIV inserts its DNA into ours. Without this capsid, HIV simply can't complete its mission. Unlike the virus's genetic material, which mutates constantly, the capsid is remarkably stable. No matter the strain, the structure remains almost identical across different types of HIV. For researchers, this was the equivalent of finding a pressure point in an otherwise invincible enemy. It was the hidden weakness scientists had been searching for. a part of the virus that could be targeted without being outsmarted by endless mutations. But finding the weakness was only the first step. The challenge was to design a drug strong enough to disrupt the capsid without harming human cells. It would take nearly two decades of trial and error before the answer finally emerged, a compound capable of binding to the capsid and destabilizing it completely. That compound became the foundation of what is now known as Lenacapavir, the revolutionary six-month injection that has redefined HIV prevention. The six-month injection, the closest we've come to an HIV vaccine. After years of research, the capsid weakness gave birth to a breakthrough drug, Lenacapavir. Unlike daily pills or short-term treatments, Lenacapavir is injected just twice a year, and its protective effect lasts for 6 full months. Here's how it works. Once injected under the skin, the drug slowly releases into the bloodstream. It binds directly to the capsid, destabilizing its structure. Without an intact capsid, HIV cannot deliver its genetic material into the cell nucleus. Even if the virus manages to enter a cell, it cannot form new capsids to produce more viruses. The infection is blocked at its very root. The results from clinical trials were astonishing. Among thousands of participants, those who received Lenacapavir showed a 96% reduction in HIV infection risk, higher than the daily preventive pills that have been the global standard for over a decade. In fact, some women became pregnant during the studies, proving that they had unprotected sex, but not a single one contracted HIV after taking the injection. So, is this the long-awaited vaccine? Not exactly. A traditional vaccine works by training the immune system to recognize and fight a virus, building long-term memory that can last for years or even a lifetime. Lenacapavir doesn't do that. Instead, it acts more like a chemical shield. As long as the drug is present in the bloodstream, you're protected. But once it wears off, the protection disappears, and another dose is needed. Even so, many experts call it the closest we've ever come to a true HIV vaccine. Why? Because for the first time, prevention doesn't depend on daily pills, condoms, or strict adherence to treatment. It's a simple injection, twice a year. And the protection it offers could finally tip the scales in humanity's decades-long battle against AIDS. But while the science is breathtaking, one major question remains. Will the world be able to afford it? The future of HIV prevention, cost, accessibility, and hope. The approval of Lenacapavir marks a historic milestone, but the battle is far from over. The biggest challenge now is not science, it's accessibility. Each patient needs just 2 injections per year, but the current cost is staggering, around $40,000 annually per person in the United States. If millions of people at risk were to use it, the financial burden would skyrocket into billions of dollars. For high-income countries, it's a matter of negotiating prices. But for low- and middle-income countries, where HIV is most widespread, this price tag is devastating. International health organizations are already pushing for agreements to produce generic versions at a fraction of the cost, especially for the world's poorest nations. Without this, the very people who need the injection most may be the last to receive it. And then comes another question. How do we ensure long-term adherence? Even with a six-month interval, patients must return for repeat doses every year, for life. Just like daily pills, missing an injection means losing protection. This is not yet the ultimate cure, but it is a leap closer than humanity has ever been. What does the future hold? Most experts believe that within the next decade, we'll see more capsid-targeting drugs, perhaps even improved versions that last longer or are easier to distribute. Combined with ongoing vaccine research, there is real hope that HIV, once thought unstoppable, may finally become a disease of the past. For now, Lenacapavir stands as a symbol of what science can achieve, taking one of the most feared viruses in history and finally exposing its weakness. The road ahead is still long, but for the first time, the end of the AIDS epidemic feels within reach. For over 40 years, HIV has been one of the most complex enemies medicine has ever faced. It mutates constantly, hides inside our DNA, and destroys the very system designed to protect us. Millions of lives have been lost, and countless others changed forever. But today, science has given us something extraordinary. A six-month injection that can reduce the risk of infection by more than 96%. It may not be a traditional vaccine, but it is the closest we have ever come to one. And it represents a turning point in the global fight against AIDS. Here's what we can take away. Treatment has evolved. From daily pills to long-lasting injections. Prevention is now stronger than ever, with options that no longer rely on daily adherence. The biggest challenge ahead is access. Making sure cost does not stand in the way of saving millions of lives. The lesson is clear. Science is moving faster than ever, and breakthroughs that once seemed impossible are now reality. But awareness matters. Knowing that these options exist, spreading the word, and demanding global accessibility are just as important as the discovery itself. So the question is, will the world rise to the challenge and make this revolutionary treatment available to everyone who needs it? Or will cost and inequality hold us back? One thing is certain. For the first time in history, the end of HIV as a global epidemic is not just a dream. It is a possibility. Stay informed, stay curious, and remember, prevention is always the best medicine.